The Amazon Relational Database Service, RDS, makes it easy to set up, operate, and scale a relational database in the cloud. It provides cost-efficient and resizable capacity while automating time-consuming administration tasks such as hardware provisioning, database setup, patching, and backups. When we think about backups, we often think about disaster recovery or data migration scenarios, but these aren't the only use cases. Let's consider another common one. Suppose we have an example database called Bank Demo running on a DB R5 large instance and taking automated nightly snapshots. Our internal analytics team wants to be able to run a high volume of intense queries on the data whenever they want. Can we make this possible for them in a safe, reliable, and cost-effective way? The answer is yes. In this demo, we're going to export an Amazon RDS snapshot from this example RDS database to S3, and then, with the help of AWS Glue, use Amazon Athena to perform queries on the exported snapshot. This will enable us to generate reports, perform computationally expensive analytical queries, combine our data from RDS with other sources to build data lakes, comply with long-term data retention requirements, and much more, all without impacting the performance or availability of our database. To get started, let's head over to the RDS console and open the list of available snapshots for our sample database. We'll choose the most recent automated system snapshot, but we could also select any snapshots we've taken manually or even create a brand new snapshot just for this exercise by using the Take Snapshot button. Next, we'll select Export to Amazon S3 from the Actions drop-down menu button and start configuring our export. Let's call it Bank Demo Export 1. Now we need to indicate how much data we'd like to export. We can either export the entire database, or we can specify only a few tables by listing the schema and name for each table that we want to include. Let's go ahead and export everything. We need to choose a destination on S3 for the export, but since we don't have one yet, let's go create it. We'll call it Bank Demo Exports, leave the default options alone, and, as a general best practice, leave the Block All Public Access setting checked. Once we've done that, we can go back to the Snapshot Export form, refresh the S3 destination section, and select our new bucket. Now we need to choose an IAM role that the snapshot export process can use to access our S3 bucket. We don't have one yet, so let's create a new role called Bank Demo Exports. The role will automatically have this IAM policy shown here, and that will allow it to read, write, and manage the snapshot exports for us. To protect our exported data, we must also provide a customer-managed encryption key from the Amazon Key Management Service, KMS. We can do this by going to the KMS console and pressing the Create Key button. We'll give the key a logical name and description, but since there are no other users in this demo account, we don't need any separate key administrators or key users at this time, so we can leave those options alone. We'll click Finish to create the key, but before leaving KMS, let's grab a copy of the key ARN and then paste it into the encryption section back in RDS. Now we can start the export. The amount of time it'll take to finish will depend on the size of the snapshot itself, but we can look in the RDS console to view the current status. For more granular progress, the AWS RDS Describe Export Tasks command in the AWS CLI will tell us how much data has been extracted and what percentage of the overall process has been completed thus far. Now that the export is complete, let's take a look at what ended up in our S3 bucket. We have two export info JSON files and a folder with the same name as our database. The first info file is the final report of the export task, and the second one breaks the status down for us by individual table, including the overall size and the data type mappings. Within the Bank Demo folder, we have separate folders for each individual table that was exported, and under each of those, we'll see one or more folders corresponding to how many partitions were created during the export process. Transactions, being the largest of the three tables, created several hundred partitions, while the accounts and customers tables only required one each. Finally, at the deepest level, we'll find the exported data in Apache Parquet format. The Parquet format is up to 2 times faster to export and consumes up to 6 times less storage in Amazon S3 compared to text formats, and we can analyze the exported data with other AWS services like Amazon Athena, Amazon EMR, and Amazon SageMaker. Let's set up Athena for that right now. First, we need to tell Athena where to find the data and what it looks like. Thanks to AWS Glue, we don't need to give Athena the details on every table and its properties ourselves, though. We can set up a crawler to go discover that for us. Let's call the crawler Bank Demo and tell it that it's going to crawl through an S3 bucket in our account under this path. Next, we'll ask it to create the appropriate IAM role for us, and, for the time being, tell it to only crawl our data store when we ask it to. And finally, we'll ask it to organize the schema information it discovers under the name bank demo. With that, the crawler is ready to go, but there's one more important task that we need to complete before running it. Remember earlier when we configured the KMS key policy, but didn't need to give anybody else permission to use the key? That's no longer the case. This crawler is going to need to crawl through our exported snapshot data in S3, which is encrypted, so the crawler, or more specifically, the crawler's IAM role, is going to need access to use that key. To grant it access, we just go back to KMS and add the new IAM role as a key user. Now let's run the crawler. This will take a few minutes to complete, depending on the size of your data, but you can expect it to finish considerably faster than the original export to S3 did. Now let's go back to Athena and run some queries. Amazon Athena supports a subset of SQL, and you can refer to the Athena documentation for a full reference. If you've ever worked with SQL before, though, you'll find the query editor fairly straightforward. As you can see, we've just counted up all of the accounts, found a random customer, and looked up the 10 most recent transactions in all of their accounts using the same general query structure that we're accustomed to. The best part is that all these queries we're running are being executed against the exported data that we have in S3. Whether we need to run a high volume of analytical queries or even just a handful of very slow queries involving columns that aren't optimized for search, we know that there's going to be absolutely no impact to the database itself. That's all great, but we don't want to have to be exporting RDS snapshots to S3 manually every time. Let's automate this. Amazon RDS uses the Amazon Simple Notification Service, SNS, to publish notifications when certain RDS events occur. These notifications can trigger an AWS Lambda function to start a snapshot export, and we can then use an AWS Glue crawler to make the snapshot data available for querying with Amazon Athena. We'll use the code provided in the AWS Samples RDS Snapshot Export to S3 Pipeline repository to deploy an example of this setup. After giving it the name of our database and the name of an S3 bucket to create for the exports, the Amazon Cloud Development Kit, CDK, will handle deploying everything. Step-by-step instructions on how to do this are provided in the repository, so we won't walk through all of that here, but we can see that after a few minutes, CDK has created everything we need to automatically export the bank demo database's automated snapshots to S3. Now let's wait a few days and see what happens. Okay, great. Our Lambda function has been exporting all of the snapshots that took place after the pipeline was set up, and we can now run our Glue crawler to make this data available to us in Athena. That's going to take a little bit longer this time, since the crawler has more data to go through, but to avoid this in the future, we could schedule the Glue crawler to run automatically each morning shortly after we expect our snapshot exports to complete. Our on-demand crawler just finished though, so let's see what's available now in Athena. Unlike in the previous example, where we had one table in the Glue data catalog corresponding to each table that we had in the bank demo database, we now have several instances of each of those tables, which correspond to the different day's snapshots. This means that we can run queries on not just the latest snapshot, but also on the earlier versions of our database in the older snapshots. These snapshot exports in S3 and the tables in the AWS Glue data catalog will build up over time though, but you can clean them up automatically by using Amazon S3 object lifecycle policies, which will transition your snapshot exports through the different tiers of storage available, such as infrequent access, Glacier, or Deep Archive automatically as they age. For more information on the S3 lifecycle policies, the RDS snapshot export to S3 feature, or any of the other services mentioned in this demo, please visit the links in the video description below. Thanks for watching.